On behalf of School of Engineering and Technology, I, Dr. Subhashish Maji, welcoming you for this interactive lecture session. Today's topic is transportation problem in linear programming. This topic is related to your course systems method. The code for that course is ET301A. Now, transportation problem is a special type of linear programming problem where we have to optimize the cost of sending the goods from different factories or origins to a different locations or destination. Now, this problem requires some special technique. The simple method cannot be applied because for this problem, there is a transportation problem. It consists of a large number of equations and constants. Today, we will discuss the transportation problem with the help of few examples. Now, the name transportation problem is given because of shifting goods from different origins to different destination, and this is an optimization problem where we have to optimize the total cost of production for sending from different origins to different destination. So, this transportation problem we will be discussing today with the help of different examples. Now, transportation problem, as I already mentioned, it is a special type of linear programming problem where the objective is to minimize the cost of distributing a product from a large number of sources or origins to a large number of destination. These problems requires a special method of solution, and today we will be discussing different techniques like northwest corner method, matrix minimization method, and a very important method, that is the Vogel's method. Now, let us pick up a problem and let us see how we can solve these problems with the help of different techniques. So, the problem is, consider a manufacturer who operates three factories and dispatches his product to five different retail shops. The table, which I will show you later, indicates the capacities of three factories, the quantity of products required at the various retail shops, and the cost of shipping one unit of products from each of three factories to each of five retail shops. Now, look at this table. This table is known as transportation table. Now, here you see there are three factories, 1, 2 and 3, and there are five destinations. We call it the retail shops, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, these are the five retail shops. Now, you see from this table that the factory capacity for 1 is 50, the factory capacity for 2 is 100, and the factory capacity for is 150. And the requirement for retail shop 1 is 100, and for retail shop 2 is 70, and the retail shop 3 is 50, and the retail shop 4 is 40, and the retail shop for 5 is again 40. So, the total requirement is 300, and all these three factories put together can supply 300 items. Now, here you see some small boxes are there. Look at this, this is 1. That means, if you want to shift one item from factory 1 to retail shop 1, the cost is 1 unit. And here you see the cost is given as 9. It means that if you want to shift one product from factory 1 to factory 2, the cost is 9 unit. And here you see the retail shop 3, if you want to shift one item from factory 1 to retail shop 3, the cost is 13. And for this factory 2, if you want to shift one item from factory 2 to retail shop 4, the cost associated is 20 units. So, we have to optimize, we have to allocate the products from factories to different retail shops, so that the total requirement is fulfilled. At the same time, the cost will be optimum. Now, if you want to write down the equations in terms of linear programming, let us see that how we can develop the equations relating to transportation problem. Here we are using x11, that is the items shifted from factory 1 to the location 1. So, amount to be transported from factory 1 to retail shop 1, this will be denoted by this x11 variable. Again x12, it means the amount to be transported from factory 1 to retail shop 2 and so on. And here x35, that means we are shifting the number of products, that is x35, from factory 3 to retail shop 5. And if you want to write down the equations, we can develop these equations, but before that let us see that what is the meaning of variable C11. C11 is the cost for shifting one item from factory 1 to retail shop 1. Again A1 is the total capacity of factory 1, A2 is the total capacity for factory 2, that is 100, and A3 is the total capacity for factory 3, that is 150. And the requirement for the retail shop B1 is 100, that means B1 denotes the total requirement of retail shop 1, B2 is the total requirement of retail shop 2 and so on. If you want to develop the equations, we can write down these equations in terms of this minimization problem, that is x11 is the number of items shifted from factory 1 to retail shop 1 multiplied by the C11. So, this is the cost of total item shifting from factory 1 to retail shop 1 and like that. So, our main intention is to minimize this function, that is C11 x11 plus C12 x12 and so on. But here subject to x11 plus x12 plus x14 plus x15, this is the total number of items shifted from factory 1 to retail shop 1 to retail shop 2 to retail shop 3 and like that. So, there are 3 factories and we are shifting the items from different locations. So, we can develop these equations in terms of number of items shifted from different factories to different locations. Now, as regard the requirement is concerned, so x11 means the number of products shifted from factory 1 to retail shop 1, x21 is the number of items shifted from factory 2 to retail shop 1 and like that. Since there are 5 retail shops, so we can develop 5 more equations. And obviously, x11 has to be greater than equal to 0 and x12 is greater than equal to 0 and so on. So, you see that the number of constants are 8. That means the number of equations are 8. So, we cannot solve these problems mathematically because the number of equations are 8 and number of variables are 15. But in this case, how to solve this problem? So, that is the point we are discussing today. With the help of transportation problem, we will see these problems can be solved and the total cost will be minimum. Here today we are going to discuss 3 transportation problem. One is northwest corner rule, second one is matrix minimization and the third one is Vogel's method. So, first of all let us take up this transportation problem for the northwest corner rule. So, in the northwest corner rule you see that we will be not considering the cost part. Here we will be only concentrating how these problems can be solved. Here you see that the capacity for factory 1 is 50, but the requirement for the retail shop is 100. So, we can shift 50 items from factory 1 to location 1, that is factory 1 to the retail shop 1. So, here all the products from factory has been exhausted because all the 50 items which are there from factory 1 is being shifted to the retail shop 1. Now, we concentrate for the second row. Here you see that the retail shop's requirement is 100, but out of 100, 50 has already been allotted from factory 1. So, what is the remaining items for the retail shop 1? That is 50. So, we can shift 50 more items, 50 more products from factory 2 to retail shop 1. So, here we have allocated here 50 items from factory 2. So, the requirement for retail shop 1, that is 100, has been fulfilled by allocating 50 items from factory 1 to retail shop 1 and from factory 2 to retail shop 50. So, 100 items that is required for retail shop 1 has been fulfilled. So, now you see that for factory 2, the total item was 100. Out of 100, 50 has been allocated from factory 2 to retail shop 1. So, the remaining 50 we can allocate for retail shop 2. But my dear friend, you look at the retail shop 2, the requirement for retail shop 2 is 70, but out of that 50 has already been shifted from factory 2. So, the remaining 20 can be shifted from factory 3 to retail shop 2. So, the retail shop 2 has been satisfied because for retail shop 2, the requirement was 70. Out of 70, 50 has been shifted from factory 2 and 20 has been shifted from factory 3. So, the requirement of retail shop 2 has been fulfilled. So, for retail shop 3, the requirement of 50. Now, for retail shop 4, the requirement is 40. So, we can shift from the remaining items from factory 3 to retail shop 4. And for retail shop 5, requirement is 40. Here you see this is the solution for northwest corner rule. But my dear friend, here we are satisfying the needs. But one very important thing is this, that we are not considering the cost factor. But in this case, the problem is solved without considering the cost factor. So, the total cost we can calculate, that is the 1 into 50 plus 24 into 50 plus 12 into 50 like that. So, the total cost comes out to be 4520. But my dear friend, here one very important thing is this, we are not considering the cost factor. We are just allocating the products from different factories to different retail shops, but we are not considering the cost factor. So, the remaining two techniques, that is the matrix minimum method and the Vogel's method, will take care the cost factor. So, let us take up the case for matrix minimum method. So, in the matrix minimum method, the first thing we will consider the cost factor. So, in the transportation table, we should see that which cost is minimum, and if there is any minimum cost, so we will allocate the maximum products from that factory to that location. So, you see this table, this is a transportation table. Here you see that the cost is minimum for factory 1 to retail shop 1. So, here the cost is 1. So, this is the minimum cost, because these are the cost given in this table. So, out of all this cost, the unit cost for shifting one factory to one retail shop, that is 1. In the first row, it comes out to be 1, but factory 1 is having the capacity of 50. So, maximum 50 we can allocate from factory 1 to retail shop 1. My dear friend, you see that you go to the next row and see that in the next row is what is the minimum cost over here. And again here from factory 2 to retail shop 5, the cost is again 1. So, we can allocate the maximum number of products for this location. Here you see that even though the factory 2 is having capacity of 100, but out of 100 only 40 we can allocate to the retail shop 5, because the requirement for this retail shop 5 is 40. So, the maximum value of 40 we can allocate in this location, that is from factory 2 to retail shop 5. Again there is a cost 1, that is from factory 3 to retail shop 3, but factory 3 is having capacity of 150. This 150 we cannot allocate to this minimum cost location, because for location 3 we can allocate maximum value 50, because 50 is the requirement for the location 3. So, we see that here we have allocated 50 items. Now, in the next phase, again we have to see that what is the minimum cost associated with this table. Now you see that 9, 13, 36, 51, then 24, 12, 16, 20, 14, 33, 23 and 26. Here this is the minimum cost, that is 9 over here, that is from factory 1 to retail shop 2. But my dear friend, we cannot allocate any item from factory 1 to location 2, because the factory 1 capacity was 50 and all these products have been shifted to retail shop 1. So, the next higher cost is 12. So, here we have to allocate the maximum number of products for this location. Here you see that for factory 2, the total capacity is 100. Out of 100, 40 has already been allotted. So, what is the remaining number of products are available for factory 2? That is 100 minus 40, that is 60. So, 60 we can allocate over here, because the retail shop 2 requirement is 70. So, out of 70, 60 can be allocated over in this location, that is from factory 2 to location 2. So, you see the next table. So, here we have allocated 60. Here the next higher value for 12, then is 13, but 13 again in this location we cannot shift, because 50 items was there for factory 2, all these items were exhausted. So, here we have allocated 50 over here, because for location 1 or retail shop 1 the requirement was 100. Out of 100, 50 number of products have already been allocated over here from factory 1 to retail shop 1. So, the remaining 50 we can allocate from factory 3 to retail shop 1. So, 50 plus 50, 100, that is here all the requirements are fulfilled. Again for retail shop 2, the requirement was 70. Out of 70, 60 has already been allocated. Then the remaining 10 will be shifted from factory 3 to the retail shop 2, that is 10. And here the requirement for factory for location 3 is 50. So, from factory 3 we can shift 50 over here, that has already been shifted because the cost is 1. Again the 40 is the requirement for location 4, we can shift from factory 3 to location 4 like that. So, this is the optimum solution for matrix minimum method. Here you see for matrix minimum method, one very important thing we have considered, that is the cost factor. Here we have taken care of the cost factor. The minimum cost we have located from this transportation table, and accordingly we have allocated the products from different factory to different locations. So, here X11 is 50 and X22, that is from factory 2 to the location 2, is 60, and X25, that is 40, and X31 is 50, because from factory 3 to the retail shop 1, that is X31 is 50, X32 is 10, and X33 is 50, and from factory 3 to the location 4 is 40. So, the requirement for retail shop is 100. So, out of 100, 50 has already been shifted from factory 1, and from factory 3 the number of items shifted from factory 3 is 50. So, the total requirement 50 plus 50 is 100. Again for the retail shop 2, the requirement was 70. Out of 70, 60 has been already been shifted from factory 2 to retail shop 2, and from factory 3 to the retail shop 2, 10, that is X32. Again X33 is 50 and X34 is 40, and C11 is 1, C22 is 12, C31 is 14, C32 is 33, C33 is 1, and C34 is 23. So, once you know different cost and different say items transported from different factory, we can easily calculate the total transportation cost. The total transportation cost comes out to be rupees 2810. Here one very important thing is this, that for the northwest corners rule the total cost was 4520, and for the matrix minimum method the cost is 2810. So, here you see that we have considered in matrix minimum method the cost factor, that is why
the cost is reduced.
Now, we will discuss the next technique for transportation problem, that is known as the Vogel's approximation method. Now, for Vogel's approximation method, it will give you the optimal solution. And for Vogel's approximation method, for finding the initial basic feasible solution involves few steps. So, first of all, let us discuss what are the steps to be carried out for Vogel's approximation method for finding out the optimal solution for this transportation problem. From the transportation table, we have to determine the penalty for each row and each column. How to calculate the penalty? For each row, you have to find out what is the lowest cost. We have to subtract this lowest cost to the next lowest cost in the same row. So, likewise, for each row, we have to calculate the penalty, and for each column also, we have to calculate the penalty. So, after calculating the penalty for each row and each column, we have to see that what is the maximum penalty for considering the rows and column. If we find the maximum penalty, then we have to see that in that row or column, which is the minimum cost, and we have to allocate the products in that location only. So, you see that how we can calculate the minimum cost by using the Vogel's approximation method. So, in this case, again I am telling to you that we have to calculate the penalty. How to calculate the penalty? For each row, you have to see that what is the minimum cost, and we have to subtract this minimum cost from the next minimum cost in the same row. Like that, we have to calculate the penalty for each row, and for each column also, we have to calculate the penalty. Now, how to calculate the penalty for each column? We have to see that what is the minimum cost in that particular column, and we have to subtract that minimum cost in that column from the next minimum cost in that particular column. So, our duty is first to calculate the penalty for each row and each column. So, let us take one example and let us see that how we can calculate the penalty for each row and each column. After that, we have to see that what is the maximum penalty, and on that basis we have to proceed further. So, let us see that how to calculate the penalty for each row and for each column. Now, you see this transportation problem. Here, the origin is 1, 2, 3, that is factory 1, factory 2, factory 3, and here we have taken 4 destination. This is the destination 1, this is destination 2, destination 3 and destination 4. The capacity for factory 1 is 120, the capacity of factory 2 is 70, the capacity for factory 3 is 50, and the requirement for the destination 1 is 60, the requirement for destination 2 is 40, the requirement for destination 3 is 30, and so 60 plus 40 plus 30 plus 110 is 240, and the capacity for factory 1 is 120 plus 70 is the capacity for factory 2, and 50 is the capacity for factory 3. So, the total capacity is again 240. So, first and foremost duty for this Vogel's approximation method is to calculate the penalty for each row and each column. Again, I am telling to you that how to calculate the penalty. We have to see the what is the minimum cost in each row. So, here you see that the minimum cost is 4 in the first row and the next minimum cost is 70. So, for calculating penalty, we have to subtract this 4 from the next higher cost, that is 70. So, for first row, the penalty is 17 minus 4, that is 13. For the second row, the lowest cost is 7 and the next lowest cost is 9. So, the penalty for the second row is 9 minus 7, it is 2. For the third row, the lowest cost is 15 and the next lowest cost is 20. So, 20 minus 15 is the 5 is the penalty for the third row. So, now we have understood how to calculate the penalty for each row. Now, as regard the column is concerned, in the first column, you see that lowest cost is 20 and the next lowest cost is 24. So, the penalty for the second column is 24 minus 20, that is 4. In the second column, you see that the lowest cost is 22 and the next lowest cost is 37. What is the penalty? That is 37 minus 22, that is 15. And here you see that 9 is the lowest cost and the next lowest cost is 17. So, 17 minus 9 is the 8, that is the penalty for the column 3. For column 4, the lowest cost is 4 and the next lowest cost is 7. So, the penalty for column 4 is 7 minus 4, that is 3. So, at this juncture, we are able to calculate the penalty for each row and each column. And let us see that how the transportation table looks like after calculating the penalty for each row and each column. Look at this table. For the same transportation table that we have introduced the penalty for row, and this is the penalty for the column. So, here it is 13, because 17 minus 4 is 13, 9 minus 7 is 2, then 20 minus 15 is 5, and here 24 minus 20 is 4, again 37 minus 22 is 15, and 17 minus 9 is 8, and 7 minus 4 is 3. So, now here we have just calculated the penalty for each row and column. The next step is to find out, out of these penalties for each row and column, what is the maximum penalty out of these penalties. So, here you see that out of these penalties, what is the maximum number? That is 15. So, we have to concentrate only on the second column, and you see that in the second column, the lowest cost is 22. So, we have to allocate the maximum number of products at this location, that is destination 2. But here, the destination 2, it can come from factory 1. So, here even though the capacity is 120, but the requirement is only 40. So, 40 the maximum number we can shift from factory 1 to retail shop 2. Fine. So, after allocating this, so retail shop 2, the requirement is fulfilled at this juncture, because 40 is the requirement for retail shop 2 that can come from factory 1, because factory 1 capacity is 120. We have to proceed in the same way as I have discussed in the, but one very important thing is this: while considering the second time for calculating penalty, we have to discard this column, because the retail shop 2 requirement is 40, that has already been fulfilled from factory 1. So, we have to discard this column, and after discarding this column, we have to calculate the penalty afresh. Now, you see that in the next case, we have omitted this column, but in this case, let us see that what is the penalty for the for different rows as well as different column. Here you see in the first row that the lowest cost is 4 and the next lowest cost is 17. So, 17 minus 4, that is 13, is the penalty for the first row. Again, for the second row, the lowest cost is 7, but the next lowest cost is 9, again penalty is 2. For the third row, 20 minus 15 is the 5, is the penalty, and for the first column, that is 24 minus 20, that is 4, is the penalty. But in this case, we will not be considering this column, because this column has already been discarded by allotting 40 from factory 1 to retail shop 2. Again, for this column, that is the third column, the penalty is 17 minus 9, that is 8, and 7 minus 4 is 3. What is the next stage? What is the highest penalty? The 13, 2, 5, 8, 3, and 4. Out of all these penalties, 13 is the highest penalty. So, we have to concentrate only this row, and we have to see that what is the minimum cost associated in this first row. You see that out of 4, 17 and 20, the minimum cost is 4. So, here we have to allocate the maximum products over here, but the requirement is 110. But out of 120, 40 has already been shifted. from factory 1 to factory 2. Here total capacity is 120, 40 has already been shifted. So, the remaining 80 we can shift from factory 1 to the location 4. So, here 80 we can shift over here. But in this case, you see, after allocating 80 from factory 1 to 4, this row we have to eliminate, because 120 has already been exhausted by shifting 40 from factory 1 to factory 2 and 80 from factory 1 to 40. Again, we have to discard this row, and we have to proceed in the same way by calculating penalty for rows as well as column, and we have to find out where is the maximum number of penalty. So, like that, here we have allocated 80 and we have omitted this row. Again, we have to calculate the penalty. Here 9 and 7 2 and 20 and 15 is 5, and in this case here that 32 minus 24, that is 8. We are not considering this 20. 20 minus 9 is 11 and 15 minus 7 is 8. Now 2, 5, 11, 8 and 8. Out of this 8, 11 is the highest penalty. So, we have to concentrate on this column by considering the minimum cost over here. 9 is the minimum cost over here. So, but the requirement is 30. So, 30 we can shift over here from factory 2, because factory 2 capacity is 70. So, 30 we have allocated over here, and we have to discard this column also. So, like that we have to proceed, and in this case you see that we have 30 we have allocated and this column we have to discard, and like that in the same way we have to allocate like this. Now, here this is the final result for this Bogle's method. 40 is a in this case 50 plus 10 is 60, that is for destination 1, and 40 for the destination 2, that is from factory 1, and 30 is the requirement for factory 3, that is coming from factory 2, and for the location 4 the requirement was 110, out of that 80 from factory 1 and 30 from factory 2. So, like that we have allocated all the products from different factories to different locations, and the cost is rupees 3520. Now, at this juncture we have discussed the three different techniques, like northwest corner rule, matrix minimum method and the Bogle's method. So, we have discussed the different optimization technique for transportation problem. This is the another problem we have taken up. So, this problem is given to you as an exercise, and you can note down this problem. There are 4 factories and there are 3 warehouses, and the cost is also there in this table. We can apply different techniques like northwest corner rule, the matrix minimum method and the Bogle's method, and here is a northwest corner rule solution. The same problem can be done through the matrix minimum method. So, I have already explained the how to solve the problem with matrix minimum method. We have to see that what is the minimum cost. The minimum cost is 2, but the minimum cost, so 26 is the requirement, but from factory B it can come only 20. So, 20 we can allocate. After that we can go to the next minimum cost, that is 3. So, here 20 is allocated, but we need not have to consider this cost, because all the factory products, that is 20, has been allocated for warehouse F, and the next minimum cost is 4. Like that we have to proceed, and the final solution is this for the matrix minimum method. Here you see that for matrix minimum method the total transportation cost comes out to be rupees 538. So, in the same way we can calculate the Bogle's method. For Bogle's method we know that how to proceed. We have to calculate the penalty for each row and each column. Here the penalty is 1, in this case also penalty is 1, because 3 minus 2 is 1, 6 minus 4 is 2 for penalty for the third row, and the fourth row the penalty is 1, 7 minus 6 1. Like that we have to calculate the penalty for each row. So, this is the next step after calculating the penalty for each row as well as each column. Here you see that the maximum penalty is 4, but the minimum cost in this column is 2. So, 20 can be shifted from factory B to warehouse F. So, like that we have to calculate the penalty for each and every row and column after say discarding this row in the first instance, because 20 has already been exhausted from factory B to factory F. So, like that we can calculate the penalties for each rows and column, and here you see the final results. From factory A to factory G is 15, and factory B to factory F is 20, factory C to warehouse G is 30, and factory D to E is 25, factory D to F is 6, and factory D to G is 4. So, total transportation cost comes out to be rupees 538. Here the balanced transportation problem we have discussed. Now, we will discuss the unbalanced transportation problem. In the unbalanced transportation problem, the demand and requirements are not same. Take a very this simple example, the availability for the plant A and B is 300 and 500, that is 800, but the requirement for all these warehouse is 300 plus 300 plus 500, 1100. So, in that case, we have to introduce an additional row, that is unsatisfied demand with 0 cost. So, the unsatisfied demand is 300. So, 300 plus 500 plus 300 is 1100. So, we have to convert this unbalanced transportation problem to the balanced unbalanced problem by introducing additional row or additional column as per the requirement of the particular problem. Today, we have discussed about the transportation problem. So, you can take up some more problems and you can solve these problems with the three techniques what we have discussed today, that is the northwest corner rule, the matrix minimum method and the Vogel's approximation method. Now, in this case you see that by ordinary simplex method or by ordinary algebra, we, as I already mentioned, that we cannot solve these problems easily because the number of equations and the number of unknowns are not same. So, in that case we have to go for the transportation problem. Now, why the name is given transportation problem? Because here we are transporting the items from different say origin or locations to different destinations. So, this is a very strong method, a powerful method in solving say operation research problem, where that lot of number of origins are there and in a lot of number of destinations are there. So, we can solve the problems easily by adopting these three rules, and nowadays that computers are also extensively used for solving these problems. If there is any further questions, that can be taken care of with through email and phone. Thank you very much.